look like bitches. You arguing on Instagram. You niggas dropping on Twitter and Facebook. Referee, I got the whistle. I just pulled up in the pistol. I just pulled up on my head.
Just want to wish you guys a good day today. I hope everybody's 2017 is going how expected. You feel me? I think I'm ahead of the game right now. I came out and tackled 2017 with a vengeance. So, you know what I mean? I got the upper hand right now. You know, in life, it's ups and downs. So, you can't always have a glorious day. So, you know, them bad days, they bound to come. You know what I mean? That's when they tell you, you know what I mean? Hope for the best, but prepare for the worst. You know what I mean? So, 2017 just done. We knocked down 1 week. We already into the second week of 2017. And like I said, I just pray everybody a nice, successful year. And I hope right now the year ain't shitted on you guys because it's barely started. You know what I mean? You probably started out rough, but don't give up, man. We still got a whole lot of year ahead of us. A whole lot of year, man. It just came back around. We just ended 2016 and had Christmas. You remember the holidays. Right now, we're on a whole new year, on a whole new ball game. So, you know what I mean? It might be rough. It might be tough. But believe me, this is the beginning. Don't give up, boy. Keep it going. I'm practicing being a motivated speaker. I'm trying to have a little inspiration. Keep it going. We got 365 days out the year. So you subtract whatever we just passed on right now. From today's date, keep it going. I don't care how bad your year been in 2017, you still got a lot of year left. You know what I mean? If I see you at the end of the year, and you still complaining and still having situations, we don't know what else to say, man. I guess that's what your life is going to be about. Because I'm telling you, keep it going right now. It's my man's birthday over here. This is what a birthday look like, you know what I mean? When you're working and still being productive. You know what I mean? We don't have time to take lunch breaks and, you know what I mean, go places. So, you know, sometimes takeout or delivery comes to you. You feel me? Takeout and delivery, and you can still work. You know what I mean? We take smoke breaks. You best believe we take, and I'm not talking about cigarettes. And I'm not talking about controlled substance. I'm talking about backwoods with good trees in it, man. We take smoke breaks, but when it's time to eat, you feel me? You eat and you work, man. You know what I mean? Me, I'm working right now. My job, I get paid just to talk. I talk and think, you feel me? So a lot of y'all be like, man, this boy talk a lot. Guess what? I talk a lot, boy, for a reason.
Hi, I'm Allison with Plastics Make It Possible. And we're here to...
You know what I mean? Once again, can y'all say happy birthday to Batman? I'm Robin. That's Batman. Say happy birthday, man. It's his birthday. We having a birthday meal. Look at that, man. By the way, that's turkey sausages, man. That's the birthday boy right there, man. He works on his birthday. People want that. Days off, want to go turn up and drink and shit, man. It's called spirits. You want to go drink, you know, your spirits. They call it spirits for a reason, man. It's my man's birthday. He decided to come. He wanted to work, you know what I mean? I came in to work with him. And guess what, man? We having a birthday dinner. You know, not birthday dinner, but it's my dinner. I only eat one time a day. You know, if I had this big meal right now, you better believe the rest of my day I'm eating gummy worms, some licorice, some ice cream and cereal, but I'm not gonna eat a meal ever again today. This is my breakfast, lunch, and dinner, but happy birthday, Batman. And I'm Robin. Batman. Yep. What's up, Derek? Hope 2017 is a blessing for you all so far, family. You know what I mean? Like I was telling the people before you got up on here, man. You know, 2017 just started. We knocked down a week already. You know what I mean? Whatever we're going through, you know what I mean? For real, if it's not life-changing and situations that some of my family members, you know what I mean, we all go through, and I pray all the time for everybody. I pray every time for everybody. I might not even know y'all personally on my Facebook, but guess what? If you're on my Facebook page, I prayed for you this morning. You know what I mean? Because I want you guys to have a good 2017-18. You can't just say, can I have a good 2017? You know what I mean? 2017, these years is too short. Boy, you got to start adding them together. With me, the years start coming rolling by and coming together. I added 4 years into one. I need to take care of 2017, 18, 19, 2020. Feel me? While y'all worried about 2017, I'm still focused on 2018, 19, how I'm going to go ahead and grab it by the jugular. You feel me? Because when 2020 come rolling around, I might want to poot on it. You feel me? I just want to just fart and just have it run away. You feel me? But other than that, 2017, 18, it's going to get mangled, boy. Y'all thought it was a Boston Strangler? Man, watch what I do to these 2017, 18s. If God can keep me breathing and keep me healthy, y'all going to witness some shit right now, boy. You know what I mean? These years is coming rolling around, man. You got to buckle down. Somewhere down your life, you got to grow the fuck up and buckle down and pay attention to time. Pay attention to these years, man. A lot of y'all is on spirits and your mind ain't completely there. Me, myself, I'm a loose screw. I got screws missing, man. I'm trying to tell you, boy, every day I'm trying to, while I'm brushing my teeth, I'm got a screw I'm trying to put back together, boy. You know what I mean? So it's mind over matter. Don't sit up there and be like, oh, I was drunk last night, so that's why I woke up with her. Nigga, you could wake up with a pig then if that's the fucking case. You know what I mean? Spirits. Spirits, y'all, you know, y'all, I ain't a hypocrite, so you know what I mean? Make sure you guys juggle them spirits down, you know what I mean? Kind of appropriately, you know what I mean? Because life right now is a new year. We had a lot of New Year's and a lot of Christmases and Thanksgivings to go ahead and have spirits down your system. Now, 2017, I don't understand why you guys don't have a book or some creativity. They got a YouTube tutorial. You know what I mean? YouTube tutorial is very interesting. You know what I mean? If you get on YouTube tutorial and get you a little takeout or delivery, you know what I mean? Takeout or delivery. You guys want to go over there and do some nonsense, man, and go do it because it look cute. You know what I mean? Takeout delivery. My man is on his little, you know what I mean? That's what he do on his break. But I guarantee you what, after this takeout and that delivery is already gulped up, believe me, we back in action, boy. And believe me, we being productive. And believe me, we ain't on no spirits. We ain't over here bullshitting. We ain't over here lying. We ain't over here pretending to work. We over here getting mad because we don't have enough work. You feel me? Where all I'm trying to do is lead by example. You guys ain't seen me flex no money. You know what I mean? I don't even flex no jewelry. I got a gold rosary and some rosaries on. But I'm rich at heart. You go get the nigga with the most money right now, and I guarantee you, me and him could conversate with each other, and guess who's going to leave out that room appropriately? You feel me? Because at the end of the day, he ain't going to shit on me financially. Spiritually and mentally, I already know he ain't going to be able to handle me. And physically, he don't even want to go there. You kind of see what I'm saying? So this is where I just lead by example. I done been through some shit. And I don't want y'all to go through some shit, because getting shot and going to jail for not snitching, that shit ain't fun, boy. So y'all better take it from me and what I've been through, and better be glad I'm here to explain. You kind of understand I'm explaining out of life experience what not to do and what to do. I'm not a dictator. I keep telling y'all that. I would never, a dictator will get beat the fuck up by a nigga like me, because I don't like that dictating shit. But to lead by example, we need more people to stand up to the plate and lead by example. They're too self-centered, and they don't know how to lead by example. You feel me? So right now, me, myself, for my guys like Derek and other kings out there, you know what I mean? There's a lot of kings out there, man, but they're being productive. So the ladies that's looking for, it's a lot of you ladies like, man, there ain't no more good dudes out here. Stop it. There ain't no more good ladies out here because you can't find us. Stop it. You feel me? There is kings out here, baby. You feel me? And some of us is snatched up already. Some of us is being productive. And some of us is waiting to fucking till the right one come, because a lot of y'all females is fucked the fuck up. Y'all want to sit up there and talk about dudes, boy. Can y'all be productive? Can y'all stop taking the easy way out? Gold diggers. You feel me? And it's 2017. Remember that. Me, I'm focused for 2017, 18, 19, 2020. So if you're not reading a book, if you're not paying attention to reality, if you're not paying attention at all, don't talk to me, because we don't use the same vocabulary. You feel me? I'm trying to tell you, this is where the hype diminish. The hype is going to diminish. And this is where reality prevails. I'm telling you, I represent reality, a big dose of it. You know what I mean? I'm formulating it, cooking it up, brewing it, because I'm finna serve a dose of reality that y'all ain't never seen before, boy. And I don't care how much money a nigga can have a meatloaf sandwich of money right here on the side of his head. If he can't speak the vocabulary with a meaning and stand for a purpose and be a part of a movement and a structure, that boy just money. Meatloaf sandwich. Cash the fuck out. Cans. Aluminum. You feel me? Aluminum cans is like the same as y'all niggas with the meatloaf sandwich. Aluminum cans is worth something. I don't care if it's a little bit, because a lot of you niggas with meatloaf sandwiches with the money right here to your ear, like how I used to do it, except I have quality about myself, but y'all do it right here and don't know what you're doing it for. You kind of see what I'm saying, but meatloaf sandwich, sir. You know what I mean? The same thing what you're doing right here might be all the money that you own in your life. You feel me? Half of y'all niggas is flexing, and it's all the money you own in your fucking life, man. Somebody could go ahead and blop you upside the head, and then what you gonna do? You gonna go from meatloaf sandwich to, you know what I mean, hoping upon a call? You feel me? So, the value of yourself, bro, is the same as an aluminum can. You birth worth something. But what is your quality? Understand what I'm saying? I told you, I'm leveling it up. I don't know what the fuck you guys is doing, bro, but we leveling up, and I'm telling you, this is the underworld, boy. Y'all too consumed on what the world is doing, the rich and famous, the world, y'all worried about it. But in the underworld, boy, we come from the most deprived, the poor, you know what I mean, the unfortunate, and we was tired, man. We is tired of asking, so we had to educate ourselves. We had to survive by any means necessary. And we had to get sharper, boy. And we had to watch what we put out there, boy. And we had to watch what we show, boy. Because you know what? Success in the underworld is not made to be seen, boy. You feel me? I used to, boy, but guess what? I done wisened up, boy. I don't gotta look over my shoulders no more, boy. This is... What y'all wanna do, man? Look at this right here. Y'all didn't know they got turkey sausages? Look at the turkey sausage. Tastes the same like beef, boy. Turkey. You know what I mean? Got a little biscuit and gravy with a little potatoes. That's probably what I'm gonna eat, man, because it's meat right here. I don't know. Even turkey getting on my fucking nerves nowadays. Have a little egg, a little waffle. It's supposed to be a Beijing waffle, but all I see is... See, man, you gotta pay attention to shit, man. I want a Beijing waffle. Does that look like that's from Beijing? I could have got it in the kitchen and they made me a plain waffle out the freezer with some syrup. You feel me? That ain't Beijing. That's ghetto. You feel me? But what's up, family? What's up, Mouse? What's up, Mouse? Look how the underworld, baby. I'm coming home today. I'm finna go. In fact, guess what, guys? I'm hitting the road today. I'm going to California today. In fact, where am I going today, family? Tell these. Am I going to California sometime today? It was my man's birthday today, you know what I mean? Batman and I'm Robin. And we at the Underworld Status compound having takeout and shit. You know what I mean? Plotting and planning, working today. Being productive. Eating turkey sausages and shit. Being burnt to mouse. They don't understand. We burnt out, man. We come from that East Bay, Hayward and Oakland era. We represent the Bay, at least I do. You know what I mean? I got people in San Jose, Frisco, Richmond. You know what I mean? Hayward, Fremont, Livermore, Vallejo, Fairfield, Santa Rosa. I fuck with the Bay, boy. And where I come from, I got a few screws loose, boy. Y'all gotta understand. A different cloth, man. I'm back to 100 after 19 gunshots, boy. I could finally say I'm back in position, man. People was fucking with me as half-ass man, boy. I was out there, like I said, half-ass. Half-ass. You get shot up, how can you give people your full capabilities? How can you promise people your best potential? How can you be your best? You just got to give it your best shot and keep moving. If God could allow you to breathe and you get shot, and I pray to God people don't get shot, bruh. Me, myself, I'm representing a positive force. I'm trying to eliminate genocide little by little. I'm not a hypocrite. You feel me? I come from the land of the tough and the rough. But at the same time, boy, bullet holes don't have no names on it. And believe me, they hurt. If you can survive it, it hurts more, boy. They tell you bullets kill you. They kill you. But at the same time, boy, you survive that shit, your bones hurt when it rains. You riddled up, boy. Your mind is fucked up. But you control that shit. Mind over matter. Keep it pushing. Be half-assed. Whatever percentage you is. I don't care if you don't have limbs. You got to get your legs amputated. If you can still think, still produce. You're still living. Still be something in this world. But see, with me, it was hard, man. But my mind right here, my consciousness, my game, my smartness, it's up there, boy. Y'all didn't understand, boy. It leveled up, man. And when somebody tried to take my life, it woke my game up like that white light switch, man. All my senses. I got more than five senses, boy. My third eye is even open right now, boy. I see y'all. Y'all don't see them little eyeballs, boy. I'm fucking seeing right now, boy. I'm trying to tell you, reality is finna prevail. Whoever living the hype, boy, y'all better go over there and get the rehearsing. Y'all need y'all hype. The hype is running out. It's running out, boy. Whoever over on them Instagram, over there doing all that shit and shit. Over there, you that shit, boy. The hype is running out, boy. The epidemic of the underworld, boy, is creating a lifestyle. If you don't understand what I'm saying, underworld, y'all think it's I'm making it corporate right now. But the underworld is really a lifestyle. You know what I mean? It's being implanted. Implanted through communities. Through communities. You hear me what I'm saying? This is where the world meets the underworld for real, for real, for real. You know what I mean? Implanted into communities. And what the world didn't want to do, we're going to enlighten them. We're going to give them little jobs. You know what I mean? We're going to go ahead and give them entertainment. We're going to get people productive, because when people is productive, it ain't no time to be on dope and on gang banging and all that shit. And like I said, I done been through that, so I'm not a hypocrite. I'm not telling nobody to debrief. I'm not telling nobody not to smoke no dope. I'm just leading by the example. I done been the fuck out there, and I don't think some of y'all can handle it these days. You want me to rewind that? I don't think some of y'all today can handle the shit that we have to go through. You understand? Tell a mouse. These dudes, boy. Tell them, Derek. These dudes, boy. Tell them, Miss Badgett. These dudes, boy. They don't understand, man. People don't understand, man. You know, I understand that, you know, the Uzis and the little Uzis and the little Yakis and 21 Savages is the guys that represent, you know what I mean, what y'all represent. And I don't know what kind of clouts and shit that is. And me, myself, I'm not even a battle rapper. I don't rap. I don't even entertain. I'm just tired of seeing people sitting up there hollering about real this, real nigga that, real whatever. What about the real kings, boy? What about the real bosses? What about the real owners? What about the real men? What about the real structures? What about the real movements? You kind of understand what I'm saying? You think today, 2017, I give a fuck about a nigga telling me he real? Really? Really? What the fuck have you really done, nigga? You know what I mean? All that, oh, I'm real, keep it 100, that shit don't apply in my bracket, because I actually already know somebody. When I see them straight from the, they first approach to me, they don't got to tell me they real or nothing. I could already tell off top what the fuck they is. If they powder puff, if they real, if they make believe, if they the feds, if they hip hop police, if they whoever the fuck they is, I could tell who the fuck they is just by eye communication. So a nigga sit up there and be like, oh, bro, I'm a real ass nigga. Nigga, shut the fuck up. Get out of my face, nigga. What have you done lately, nigga? We over here being creative, nigga. You want some of these screws to come unloose and want me to reel on that? You feel me? See what I'm saying? Everybody got a maker in life, man, and we always got to remember that. Look at me, boy. I got a few screws. Listen, look at me. Why am I touched up 19 times? What that boy say? He's dropped magnificent. Why is he touched up 19 times? That boy done been out there winning 29 years consistently since 13 years old, boy. Since 13 years old, boy, to right now, boy, I've been out there in the streets, but why am I hit up 19 times, boy? So everybody got a maker, so everybody got to get off that motherfucking hype, boy, because we all can bleed and we all somebody, boy, but what can we do lately? Can we get with a bunch of guys? Look at, I'm going to California today, but family, did I stay back today for your birthday? And look at what we having, man, some takeout. You feel me? We're over here in the corporate office right now, boy. Look at right here. On his sectional. Got me a little speaker right here. You know what I mean? Got me a little speaker. And I want you guys to know, man, everything ain't what it seems. Everything that glitter ain't gold. Because you guys might see shit, boy. But you think we spending top notch? You think we over there scourging money? Boy, we ain't no flexors, boy. I've been stressing too long in life, boy, to sit up here and waste some motherfucking money, boy. It's not what you know, it's who you know. You could go over there to that motherfucking store over there, like I keep telling y'all, and go buy something. Me, myself, I'm going to have a little patience, boy. And I'm going to sit over there and let whatever y'all go buy come the fuck to me out here in this underworld. So while you go spend $5,000 on it or something, over here in the underworld, boy, you might smoke a little weed and donate, because I don't sell shit, but I donate some weed. You may be on one of them whittle days, boy, and just the struck of his luck, which you wouldn't have bought. This nigga didn't bought the same thing, but it's not useful in his life. So guess what, boy? I didn't smoke some weed with the nigga, gave him a few backwoods and stuff, donated him some trees to go, you know, tighten up his screws and things, sort out his problems so he could get busy again. And guess what, man? I got the same item you got, and you was fooled. You was fooled. I don't think y'all understand that, man. Y'all keep wasting shit and keep doing shit and keep complaining and shit, boy. This is, like I said, motherfuckers are living the hype. This is where reality prevails. We ain't doing nothing over here in the underworld but cooking up reality, boy. This is where loose lips sink ships. This is where people's talk. You better be speaking this shit into existence, because after that, boy, I'm telling you, it's gonna be lonely days out there in that cold. It's 2017, boy. While y'all still figuring out 2017, I'm already, like I said, on 2019. 2017, I plotted and planned it on 2017. Go back and look down my timeline. You guys keep seeing what I put down there. Right now, I'm putting 2017, 18, 19, 20, 20. I'm not focused on 1 year. I'm focused on 4 years, boy. 4 years. You know what I mean? 2013, 14, I was just telling you guys 2015, 16, 17 what I was doing. So if you guys see what I'm doing, boy, I'm speaking and thinking shit into existence, but at the same time, with mind, body, and soul, I captured my own time, and I'm going ahead, boy, and I'm putting shit in order in my life. After 19 gunshots, boy, I'm not out here living no fucking hype. I give a fuck about fame. I give a fuck about likes. I give a fuck about popularity. I give a fuck about all that shit, boy. You know what I mean? Because why people want to be celebrities, I was already a ghetto celebrity. Why people want to be rich, the nigga ghetto rich. Why nigga people want to sit up there and be famous and shit? Don't you think I'm famous? Why they want to be a star? I'm a ghetto star. There's a difference, man. When you come from the most deprived and the poor, the unfortunate, you know what I mean? Believe me, you get blessings. And what y'all see in my life right now is a blessing from God, because I didn't have faith through it all. Through it all. And like I said, some people, they sit up there and they glorify shit. Me, my success, it didn't come with no glory. It didn't come. Right now, I'm praising God and glorifying God. And shit in my life, I fucked my life up. And by the thanks of God, he let me go ahead and reevaluate some shit, fix some shit, and here I am now with y'all seeing. But now what am I gonna do? Y'all don't even know what I'm gonna do. All I did was just fix myself to this point. So with the people that's oohing and aahing from what the fuck they think they seen, with confidence, because you kick the cockiness up out of it. Fuck cockiness. We don't like cocky motherfuckers. But with confidence, confidently, I got some work to do. And I'm finna do some producing. And those that know me already understand, y'all see my history, and the ones that don't, do your history on my homework, brother. Because for the last 10, 11 years that I've been out of sync, dealing with 19 fucking gunshots, bro. I don't want to see nobody be out of sync dealing with anything. But how the fuck do you get over being out of sync dealing with 19 gunshots the last, from 2005 to right now, 2017, and you still here, got your big bobblehead on live, Facebook Live, talking to people, talking about what you gonna do, talking deep, talking not like a dictator, but by somebody that's leading by example. Come on, bruh. It's more than ambition. It's more than determination. This right here is a divine moment that you guys is witnessing through a divine movement. Underworld status don't gotta be light. It's a lifestyle already that's gonna be embedded. And I'm over here just the forefront right now, embedded it as a king. Me, myself, I got work to do for God and myself. So when I say that I'm finna produce the dose of reality, we don't take lunch breaks. We over here in the office. It's my man's birthday. We over here working. You guys don't see no spirits. Y'all don't see no liquor. Y'all don't see nothing. Y'all just see real work. You know what I mean? Real work, boy. Somebody could come over. Nah, we close to the public, though. That's the sad thing about it. when you close to the public and shit, boy, you know what I mean? Ain't no just no popping up, because I've been hit 19 times and I don't trust shit, boy. So you better believe, boy, somebody pop up, they gonna pop up out of there, boy. And then they gonna still have their life, but they gonna be brutalized, boy, because it's just like you get a pet bull that was in a pet bull fight. Just imagine me, a pet bull, and I've been in plenty of pet bull fights. But then they came over there like, what's that boy's name? Michael Vick. They came over there to Michael Vick's, and I was one of them pet bulls that they done snatched up over there. You feel me? But then they put me inside of a rescue kennel. You know what I mean? Now they done showed me, you know, they patting me and caress me. A vicious pet bull, they rescued me, and I don't know what to think. You know what I mean? I'm just right here just, you know what I mean? I got saved from something. I've been out there battling all my life and been scarred and been biting and viciously going through shit. You feel me? So now, here these people right now, they gradually, you know what I mean, put me into play. You know what I mean? So now, the boy is resting. You know what I mean? But now, when you got that rescue pit bull and you feed them and you're giving them water and shit, I'm going to go ahead and drink that water. You know what I mean? Eat a little bit and shit. You know what I mean? But after that, somebody yell at me, boy, or put their fist up, boy, they might get mauled. You hear what I'm saying? You don't. When you see a rescue pet bull and they save it, and you want to be a adopter, you want to adopt one of them dogs, don't you ever yell at it or fucking raise it, boy, because I did that, boy. And that nigga was nice to all the way through until I said, nigga, what the hell? You chewed on some couch? That nigga came after them ankles, boy, and I had to hit that nigga with an uppercut, throw that nigga out the door, and lock my fucking door, boy. You got to understand what I'm saying. I come from the most deprived, boy, and I tamed myself. I'm still that go-getting, that one dude, boy. My life is built off controversy. We ain't doing all that no more. We eliminating genocide. We gotta pave the way for the youth and the younger generations. The world can't do it by itself. So that's when the underworld and the world, two different worlds, you got the world and the underworld, has to gradually, carefully come together and coexist. You see what I'm saying? And if a person like me that represent the underworld could buckle down and be a gentleman, start reading books and educating myself, start doing the right things, then why is these motherfucking has-been niggas, the niggas that's in the fucking way, the niggas that's living the hype, the niggas that's over there on that strip up to no good, being non-productive, lying on Instagram and shit, why the fuck can they not buckle down, boy? That hype shit, boy, is, I'm trying to tell you, reality, boy, is pissed the fuck off. You know what I mean? I got a lot of kings, boy, that's living reality. A big dose of it, boy. There's millions and millions and millions and millions and millions of motherfuckers living the hype. So somehow, like a bowling ball, without taking people's lives, boy, because we're eliminating genocide. But some way, like a bowling ball, we got to hit. I'm going to go ahead and go for the strike. I need that ball. Because it's too much hype out there. If you go after it, boy, and you miss it, that hype might come back and eat your ass up. So with a dose of reality, you got to go ahead, boy, and get up to that line, measure it, just like bowling, and swing it all the way back and hit it, boy, in that little point, strike. Understand? Y'all let them niggas know, boy, it's serious, because we over here, bro, in the office, we don't take lunch breaks, we take smoke breaks. Backwoods, no swishers. Feel me? Backwoods, no swishers, boy. Look at Batman over there. He up to something, boy. When y'all see him like that, he either editing, he networking, he talking to somebody on the East Coast. He over there up to something. Look at that. He ain't said, it's his birthday. It's his birthday, man. I asked him, I said, what you want to do on your birthday? He said, what? He said, we work. It's a passion. To these people, y'all say slaving. Some people say slaving or, oh, man, I got to go to work. Boy, you better be grateful you going somewhere. Be grateful. It's 2017, boy. There's starving people out there. There's homeless people out there. There's people hoping and wishing out there. There's people lying out there. And there's people living a motherfucking hype, boy. You know what I mean? Be grateful about something, man. I wouldn't even give a fuck, boy. Because I'm alive, I'm grateful for that, boy. Right now, God could have kept me alive, boy. And I wouldn't be at no fast food place. But you better believe I'd have been inside Walmart or Target behind in that warehouse somewhere on the forklift, boy. Y'all wouldn't even know I worked there. But guess what? I'm so business savvy with it. I'd have been over there in that forklift place where y'all wouldn't even know. Y'all been like, where the boy at? And out of them 8 to 12 hours, boy, that would have saved my life from going to jail or dying, because I would have been over there at that work establishment right now being productive. But y'all too cute. Y'all too cute for that shit. So y'all keep wishing upon the star. And y'all keep wishing upon the call. And y'all can be wishing upon whatever the fuck y'all want to, because y'all ain't paying attention to reality. Y'all, that hype keep having y'all spend y'all money on the ridiculous ass shit. You know what I mean? Somewhere down the line, I did my homework and I done heard some things about, you know what I mean, the black community. And some things is, you're living above your means. And I was living above my means. You know what I mean? Everything don't have to be named motherfucking brand, boy. Just make it look good. You know what I mean? When you come from the ghetto, you might have a pair of Nikes on. You know what I mean? No true. You can look at these. These ain't true religions. You know what I mean? Look, I got some LeBrons on. Okay, that's the name. I got some, you know what I mean? We do our own shit, boy. My man over here, he does fashion. I got my own clothing line. So you think we're going to keep going over there and buying people's shit? And we could go over there and go get us some jeans, boy, and rip them up ourselves and create our own fashion and put on an Underworld Status sweater or Underworld Status shirt or Underworld Status beanie or Underworld Status hat. Y'all like that marketing, huh? But yeah, you know what I mean? Y'all over there living the hype and shit, boy. And we over here, like I said, we cooking up, formulating, putting some ingredients together. You know, saucing it up. You know what I mean? Season it up. Look at them potatoes and shit, boy. See how them potatoes is so nice and seasoned? We putting a little seasoning on it. And boy, I'm finna serve y'all a big dose of reality. So y'all tell the hype, boy, whatever they cooking up over there, the huddle up, the hype. Go get all the hype men. Tell them to huddle up like they playing football. And they better get the gossiping. They get it, better get to doing whatever the fuck they do. Because right now, when reality prevail, something's finna go ahead and diminish. And I don't think reality diminishes. You feel me? I've been living my life in a reality trip for so long. Living my original. I'm living original. From the time I was in my teens to right now, the people that witness my life and the ones that don't, go do your homework on my history. I'm living original. These people that your boy become executive producer in the music movie industry. You feel me? And one thing is, I'm not new at this. Because from 13, boy, with Babes, Man, Dre 5, Kev, you feel me? Man, Big Reese, you feel me? Alex, Jesse, you feel me? We was from that era, bruh. That thug life. So you feel me? At 13, all the way to right now, I might have not been in the spotlight, but I've been like that on the grid of the industry and the streets. Industry and streets. Industry and streets. Industry and streets. You kind of understand what I'm saying? I never want to be an entertainer. I never want to be a rapper. I didn't want to be none of that, boy. I've been living my life in a reality, boy. Life been so hard, boy. I've been out there surviving and go getting it, boy, where my life became a fucking movie. How the fuck you don't got no entertainment, boy, but you at the top of the food chain, boy. Executive producer, CEO, dealing with shit on the business aspect of shit. You feel me? This is this the industry. This the underworld, boy. Same services, same everything, man. You know what I mean? Y'all you guys used to understand the underground used to be happening. You had the people didn't make it to the industry, so they did underground shit. I don't know what the underground is, but I know what the underworld is, boy, because that's the lifestyle I've been living, boy. I've been living my life boss. I've been living my life king. I used to be a real nigga, but I ain't calling myself that. There's too many real niggas on earth. They look like ants. You know what I mean? Them niggas is over there like all over the place and shit. And real niggas is commercialized nowadays. You feel me? This shit is ridiculous. I had to learn how to be a man. You feel me? I had to go from a real nigga to a man. Then a man, I didn't want to be just an average man. So I had to be an owner or something. Then I went from being an owner to, you know what I mean? I always know, but I had to go ahead and define boss. There's, you know what I mean, another level. King. You feel me? King. You feel me? So, why niggas is real niggas, why niggas is men, why niggas is bosses, why niggas is fabricators, why niggas is lying, ask my mama, boy. Kafunya means king, boy. I don't just call myself king. I just don't call myself king, boy. Kafunya means king. Do it. Google something. When you guys do your research and Google, when you sit up there, boy, and do your research and do YouTube tutorials, when you pick up books and stop wasting your time on commercialized shit and watching TV and listening to media and listening to gossipers and listening to liars, you'll find out what reality stands for. Other than that, boy, I'm not finna produce nothing else to y'all, man. I don't give a fuck if 1,000 to 1,000,000 y'all don't like me. Because when you produce reality organically,
Believe me, it's gonna prevail. It's gonna prevail. Literally, boy, it's gonna prevail. You know what I mean? So, you know what I mean? I gotta get over here and get on this. You know what I mean? I got a little biscuits and gravy with the potatoes, little eggs and turkey sausage. You feel me? I'm trying to become a vegetarian. I'm trying. You know what I mean? At least I'm trying, boy. Some of y'all niggas don't try to do shit. You feel me? And they got me because I wanted a Beijing waffle, and that looked like a plain ghetto waffle. You understand what I'm saying? I could have did that at a kitchen. You know what I mean? But we cool. We gonna go ahead, boy, because I'm at work right now in the office. You know what I mean? Sitting on the sofa, boy. It's my boy. Say, y'all say happy birthday one more again. We about to get off this gig. You know what I mean? It's his birthday. He want to come in here in the office. You know what I mean? Of course, you know what I mean? Brainstorm. It's 2017, 18, 19, 2020 that we got to worry about while y'all got to figure out 2017. We got 2017, 18, 19, 2020. You know what I mean? We're going to work and eat. We're going to take a smoke break. You know what I mean? The backwoods. Never see no swishers. You know what I mean? We're going to put some good trees in it because we don't do no controlled substances, and I don't drink. I don't do the spirits. You know what I mean? I got a few screws missing, so I don't need to drink, boy, because me, I'm going to approach with the hype a whole different way where it ain't no great bodily harm. If I get a little spirits in myself, boy, believe me, I'll be like Rampage. Y'all remember that game back in the day when them dudes was up on that building and beep, 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 beep? I think I was the King Kong dude, and my brother was like the dinosaur dude, boy, but we was on them buildings crushing that shit, boy, where, you know what I mean? If I drunk a little spirits and was out there like I used to be living, boy, it might have been some great bodily harm on the hype. But what reality is gonna do today, 2017, 18, 19, 2020, we're gonna eliminate genocide, and we're gonna verbally abuse and verbally assault these niggas that's living the hype. And they could pull out their money all they want to, because reality is we got money too, but we don't flex, we don't show it. The best money to have is the money you don't see, but you still could go get shit. You still, your bills, your priorities, all that shit is still growing. The necessities are still happening. That's the best money to have. You gotta understand, I had to find out the hard way. People say, who was you at beef with? Who was you warm with? Nobody. I just was flexing too much, boy. I was a go-getter flexing, putting it on them, boy. Putting it on them. Guess what, boy? All that flexing and being cocky and all that shit to get you 19 gunshots put in your ass, so don't do that shit. You know what I mean? I'm not a hypocrite, like I said. I'm not gonna tell nobody to debrief. You could be in the gang, you could hustle, you could do whatever the fuck you did, because I did it. But by the grace of God, I'm here. You know what I mean? So we're gonna go ahead, man, and listen to, you know what I mean, with my new speaker and shit. You know what I mean? It's my birthday. You know what I mean? Food. Dose of reality coming out the verbally, out the coming on my lips. 17, 18, 19, 20. I pray for everybody. You know what I mean? It's gonna be blessed years if God allows us to stay breathing. You know what I mean? Because it's all in God's hands. We just gotta keep faith. But if we allow ourselves to breathe, then that's what we're gonna do. We're going to breathe and we're going to keep succeeding, because we're going to stay productive. And it's not called slavery or work. It's a passion. Find a passion up under your ass and go ahead and get out there and do. You know what I mean? Say your prayer. Say your prayer and go ahead and follow your prayer and speak, think, and pray your stuff into existence. Don't just pray and just wish for it to come. Pray, get up, and follow your prayer and pray it into existence. That's what we're learning to do these years, okay? 2017, 18, 19, 2020, we working together and we trying it out. All right.